Hey friends, welcome to my channel Every Brides of India. मैं हूँ गुंजन सिंह और आज हम बात करेंगे the beautiful and very famous दीपिका पादुकोण की. She is attending World Economic Forum 2020 in Davos, Switzerland. And it is not just that, she also got a Crystal Award for her works at World Economic Forum. For this occasion, she is wearing a navy blue color gown which is by Alex Perry Official. And guys, she is looking so stunning in this beautiful navy blue color dress. She paired this dress with blue white earrings. She is styled by Shalina Nathani and Raghav, and she is looking stunning in one more white color dress which she is wearing for the WEF event. For another day at WEF event, she is wearing Gosher Paris outfit, a black outfit in which she is looking breathtaking. She completed her look with chopard jewelry, and in this look she is looking totally a stunner. She is styled by Shalina Nathani and Raghav. So friends, how do you find Deepika Padukone look at WEF? You can comment about this thing, hot or not. Okay, bye-bye, take care, sayonara, do like, comment and subscribe.
Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in congratulating Deepika Padukone for receiving the 2020 Crystal Award.
Thank you, Mrs. Schwab, Professor Schwab, and the World Economic Forum. It is truly an honor and privilege to receive this award. In the time that it has taken me to accept this award, the world has lost one more person to suicide. That person may have been a father, a mother, a son or daughter, a brother or sister, a friend, a family member, or a colleague. Every 40 seconds, one person dies by suicide somewhere in the world. $1 trillion. That is the estimated impact caused by anxiety and depression on the global economy. 15th February 2014, I vividly remember waking up with a hollow feeling in my stomach. I felt empty and directionless. I'd become irritable, and for someone who loves to multitask, making decisions suddenly felt like a burden. I would cry endlessly. Waking up every morning had become a struggle. I was exhausted, and I often thought of giving up. My mother, who recognized that something was amiss, insisted I seek professional help. Subsequently, I was diagnosed with anxiety and clinical depression. What is anxiety? It is a state of worry over a future unwanted event or a fear of an actual situation. Depression is a common yet serious medical illness that affects how we feel, the way we think, and how we act. It is important to understand that anxiety and depression are like any other illness and are treatable. However, in my experience, acceptance is the first step to recovery. Through my journey to recovery, as I began to understand the stigma and lack of awareness associated with mental illness, I felt a deep need to save at least one life. And it was this very need that motivated me to go public with my illness and set up the Live, Love, Laugh Foundation. Live, Love, and Laugh exemplify my personal philosophy to life. The Live, Love, Laugh Foundation aims to provide hope to every person experiencing stress, anxiety, and depression, and has undertaken work in the following areas. awareness programs in schools covering over 150,000 adolescents and 16,000 teachers across 11 cities in India, funding free psychiatric treatment in low-income communities, collaborative partnerships to run continuing medical education programs in common mental disorders for general practitioners, nationwide public awareness campaigns to destigmatize mental illness, an annual lecture series featuring some of the world's foremost thinkers and achievers, and research. As key stakeholders in shaping the global mental health narrative, prioritizing mental health in the workplace and various other communities, integrating mental health curriculum in educational institutions, providing accessibility to affordable mental health care, and enhancing funding for mental health are some of the focus areas that we believe are the need of the hour. As most of us know, stakeholders for a cohesive and sustainable world is the theme for this year's annual meeting. But in order for us to truly achieve a cohesive and sustainable world, now more than ever before, we need to prioritize the needs of every individual, including those affected by mental illness. Mental illness has presented us all with a very tough challenge. But in my love-hate relationship with the illness has taught me so much. To be patient for one, that you are not alone, but most importantly, that there is hope. For in the words of Martin Luther King, everything that is done in this world is done by hope. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Xinjing has been many things. She receives the crystal.